Welcome to part 16 of the Builder Series. In this video, we'll show you how to add menus and modules to the Application Navigator to give users quick access to information and functionality. This video is a continuation of the Builder Series and uses the safety application created earlier. The safety department technicians have been using the safety app for some time and realized that a list with all the safety issues isn't the best place to start. As records accumulate, the closed issues are getting in the way, and the technicians would like to see a few pre-filtered lists to help them navigate. Luke, our safety manager, suggests adding two new options to the classic UI application navigator. One, a list of just the open issues, and the other for issues assigned to me, which means assigned to the logged in user. Although these are no-code configurations, to complete them, we need either the admin role or the delegated developer role with granted access to all file types. We'll begin by going into Studio and collapsing this side menu. That allows us to easily drill into Navigation and open the application menu for safety. At the bottom of the page, we can see the three modules associated with this menu. They were created automatically by Guided App Creator when this app was first created. These define how the three options show up here. We'll create two more for Luke. Let's start with the list of open issues. The title will appear on the menu. Rather than typing open issues, we already have a separator that groups these together as issues. So we'll just use the word open here. It would be redundant to include the word issues on each module we add to this menu section. Next is the order. Looking at the application menu record, we see 1, 2, 3 for the order of existing modules. So 4 makes sense here. The visibility section is where we could apply roles to specify who can access the module on the application navigator. But the parent application menu is already handling that, so we'll leave it blank. In the link type section, we want to create a list of records. On the issue table, and we asked Luke what he meant by open issues, because we don't have a state value of open. He said, anything that's not complete. So we'll apply the filter state is not complete. We submit that to save it. On our main browser tab, we do a quick refresh to test our results. And we now see Safety, Issue, Open in the Application Navigator. This list brings up all the issues that are not complete, as validated by the breadcrumbs beside the Show Hide filter icon. Now let's take care of Luke's other request, to show all the issues assigned to the logged in user. Again, we start from the application menu record in Studio and click New on the related list of modules. We'll title this one Assigned to Me. Give it the order value of 5 to follow our new Open module. Select the issue table again. And this time, the filter will be Assigned to Is Dynamic Me. So it uses a dynamic value of the user who's logged in at the moment. We submit that, do another refresh on the main browser tab, and there's our new module. When we click it, we have a list of issues assigned to the system administrator. If Luke uses the same module, he'll get a list of issues assigned to him. Very handy. If needed, we can also create modules accessing records on other tables, reports, dashboards, or even a specific URL. There are several options to make it easy for your users to navigate through the system. For more information, see our product documentation, knowledge base, or podcast, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community.